We've often said here at The Truth About Cancer that it's about quality of life, not just quantity of life. Today, we join Ben Fuchs as he shares the importance of the quality of life.
Plus, he also shares about fats, supplements, and strategies to fight cancer. He also gives us some great information on the ketogenic diet and why it's so useful for fighting many types of illnesses.
So cancer is not a genetic disease. It is a energy disease, and it manifests itself as a distorted membrane at the outside level, at the inside level, and the way you address membranes is by addressing fats. And that means internally, using nutritional supplements. That means in a positive sense, using nutritional supplements, coenzyme Q10, incredibly important for all membranes. Essential fatty acids, also very important for membranes. Vitamin E, vitamin A, and vitamin D. These are your fatty vitamins, E, A, and D, as well as K. Cholesterol, believe it or not, the cell membrane is largely made up of cholesterol, and this whole cholesterol hypothesis about heart disease needs to go the way of the genetic theory of cancer. Another bad idea. Really bad idea. And any biochemist who understands the critical nature of cholesterol, which is arguably the single most important molecule in your body, will tell you how laughable it is, the idea that you can somehow lower your blood cholesterol and have your heart be healthier for it. The problem with cholesterol, however, is something called oxycholesterol. Oxycholesterol is oxidized cholesterol, and that is a problem. Fortunately, that's where vitamin E comes in. This is also, by the way, the problem associated with vegetable oils. I don't know how many of you guys have been reading about health challenges that are associated with polyunsaturated or liquid oils, liquid vegetable oils. They're very fragile and they break down quickly. Vitamin E has a protective role against fat oxidation. So vitamin E with your cholesterol, if you're gonna eat a lot of eggs, make sure you're using vitamin E as a supplement. A lot of folks are now hip to eating a lot of eggs because of the cholesterol, but when you fry your eggs or you scramble your eggs, you create oxidized versions of cholesterol. So make sure you're using your vitamin E or even better, poach your eggs, or even raw eggs for that matter. Cancer loves sugar. Reduce sugar intake. I am not a food Nazi of any kind. I mean, if you put an apple pie right there and I haven't eaten all day, I'll probably eat half that pie, if not more of it. That's not the point. The point is that if you have a health challenge, this reducing your sugar intake represents a point of power for you to deal with your health challenge. I'm not here to preach about good food and bad food. I hate doing that, and we should never do it to anybody, and nobody wants to hear it. However, if you're dealing with a health challenge, and if you're dealing with cancer, this represents a leverage point for you. Reducing your sugar intake. I talked to a guy, I don't know if he's here, at dinner yesterday. He had bladder cancer. There he is, right there. I said, what did you do? He looked great. He looks great over there. John, was it?
Lee.
Looks great. Looks awesome. I said, what did you do? Cut out all the sugar, right? And whether he has the bladder cancer or not, I don't know, but he looks great. He feels great. He's got energy. He bounds out of bed. He's smiling. He's happy. This is the marker that we want to be looking for, not killing the cancer, but improving our quality of life. And whether you have cancer or whether you don't, reducing your sugar intake is going to be a good strategy for improving your quality of life under any condition, but especially if you're dealing with cancer. Eliminate problem foods. This is so important. There is no chronic disease on earth that does not begin at the level of the intestine. It cannot happen. The intestine is for several reasons for that. First of all, the intestine is where you absorb nutrients over time. And I have a video that I have on YouTube. I wish I had more time to tell you about it. It's called The Triangle of Disease. And these are the three points that all disease leads to all health challenges, all diseases: the digestive system, the blood sugar system, and what I call the adrenal thyroid complex. Work on digestion, and you can do it there's many ways to do it. For one thing, calorie restriction. You know, calories are not nutrition. Are not necessarily nutrition. In fact, calories can cost you nutrition. So calorie restriction and optimum nutrition, the so-called Cron diet, is the only proven protocol that has been shown repeatedly to increase longevity. Calories represent heat. Calor means heat in Latin or in Spanish. Calories represent work. Every time you eat calories without something to support those calories, the use of those calories, you cost your body nutrition. This is why calorie restriction is so powerful. In addition to calorie restriction, fasting, intermittent fasting. My friend Dr. Group is going to do a talk on fasting. I saw in the schedule. Fasting is such a powerful healing strategy for almost everything, even WebMD. If you go on their website, there's a whole article on multiple sclerosis and fasting. And WebMD, obviously no fan of what we're talking about here today necessarily, right? Fasting improves multiple sclerosis symptoms. In addition to fasting or alongside fasting, there's something called the ketogenic diet. Now, I don't know if there's going to be anybody talking about the ketogenic diet in cancer today or for the next couple of days, but it is very, very powerful for dealing with cancer. Very, very powerful for dealing with neurological diseases. Very, very powerful for diabetes. Very, very powerful for weight loss. Very, very powerful for everything, because that's the way we're supposed to be eating. Ketogenic diet, the ketogenic diet is a diet that leverages, takes advantage of the power of fat in order to energize the cell, or in order to energize the cell. Fat is more energy efficient. There's more bang for your buck in fat than there is sugar, and when we burn fat, we burn a cleaner type of energy. So the ketogenic diet is also very helpful. Respiration. Cancer hates oxygen. Practicing slow, deep breathing. Slow, deep breathing activates what's called the parasympathetic nervous system. Correct. The parasympathetic nervous system is your healing system. It's your anti-cancer system. So in addition to deep breathing, providing tissues with oxygen, providing the blood with oxygen, it will also activate your healing nervous system, your parasympathetic nervous system. Reduce cortisol. Cortisol, as you probably all know, is stress hormone. There's lots of ways to reduce cortisol, mental and emotional strategies. Don't underestimate the importance of mental and emotional strategies, by the way. But also you can use vitamin E and vitamin A to help balance out cortisol. There's a great supplement called pregnenolone. I don't know if you guys have heard of that, pregnenolone. That will help balance out cortisol, and also progesterone cream. Even for men, progesterone cream has a balancing effect on cortisol. Topically, you know, I include these, but these are more like doctor strategies. This is more like for killing the cancer, for removing the cancer, extracting the cancer. Black walnut, you could do some, make your own black walnut paste. Eggplant. I got a cool book here if anybody's interested. It's called The Eggplant Cancer Cure. You can make your own eggplant tincture. You can buy something called BEC5, chaparral, betalinic acid, which is found in birch, as well as rosemary, and then something called photodynamic therapy, which is where they paint a chemical on your skin and shoot light at your skin. None of those are really, obviously, they're not going to be effective at eliminating the cause of the cancer, but they can remove the manifestation of it. Other non-medical strategies topically, retinoids are incredible for a lot of things. Retinoids are the vitamin A family. You probably all heard of Retin-A or retinoic acid. That's the most powerful of the retinoids. That is chemotherapy. If you go to the oncologist for lung cancer, they'll actually give you retinoic acid, the same stuff that you get for your skin, for wrinkles, the very same stuff, because vitamin A has a very interesting ability to stabilize the growth of cells. Vitamin C is incredibly powerful. It's a little bit tricky, however, with vitamin C, because vitamin C, in order for it to be effective, has to be fat soluble, and we all know that the vitamin C molecule, or many of you probably know, is water soluble. So you need fat soluble vitamin C. This is topically what I'm talking about. It goes by the fat soluble vitamin C goes by the name ascorbyl palmitate. If you want to go real fancy, there's a form called ascorbyl tetraisopalmitate. Alpha hydroxy acids used on a regular basis can prevent actinic keratosis, which is precancer. You want to really be careful with preservatives and skincare products. There's no direct literature that talks about parabens and skin cancer or formaldehyde formers and skin cancer, but they can't be good for you. And given the link and the understanding that we all have about about toxicity in relationship to cellular cancer or cellular disease, it makes sense to avoid preservatives.
Even more great information from pharmacist Ben Fuchs. We hope you learned from this video.
And if you did, please share it on your social media. Tell your friends and family about the truth about cancer. Thank you. God bless.